Di tutti gli esseri viventi, l'uomo è l'unico che venga al mondo piangendo. Perché? Perché il pianto, dicono gli ostetrici, aiuta il neonato a respirare, dà l'avvio ai polmoni. Ebbene, noi siamo di parere diverso, crediamo cioè che l'uomo manifesti piangendo il proprio disappunto per essere venuto a cadere su questo mondo cane.
Do you remember Mondo Cane?
Mondo Cane es un documental de 1962 realizado por los italianos Cavara, Jacopetti y Prosperi. La película gozó de un escandaloso éxito, igual que otros de sus trabajos posteriores, como Adiós África, y su título acabó dando nombre al género Mondo. La falta de escrúpulos de los directores no impidió que rodaran algunas escenas únicas en la historia del documental. Hacia el final de Mondo Cane incluyeron imágenes estremecedoras de las misiones católicas en Papúa, Nueva Guinea. Wendy Beckett es una monja carmelita y virgen consagrada, historiadora que se hizo célebre internacionalmente en los años 90 gracias a unos programas sobre arte para la BBC. Ha publicado algunos libros y en el 2001 estrenó una nueva serie sobre museos de los Estados Unidos.
Andy Warhol, great artist or con artist?
And now I'm in New York to see what many people think the greatest museum in the world, the Met.
Entre ellos, el Metropolitano de Nueva York, que guarda algunos objetos sagrados de tribus de Papúa, Nueva Guinea.
Miles to the north, a Catholic mission is the last outpost of civilization. Five missionaries have been killed in these last few years before the sound of the bell awakened faith in these valleys.
It seems to me that this is the most eerie gallery in the Met. Of course, the museum is filled with galleries that show us strange and wonderful civilizations. But none is more strange than this, the Oceanic Gallery. The Usmut are a small people in New Guinea, and yet they evolved an intricate theology, which is perhaps summarized in these majestic beast poles.
Here, after hundreds of dark centuries, men discover for the first time in their lives that they have a doubt, a question to which they cannot find an answer. A vague and unknown anguish which is not hunger, nor thirst, nor physical pain, but aches like a wound just the same. It is the anguish which accompanies man from the beginning to the end of the world. But they still don't know it. They discovered the world and themselves only yesterday. And today, already, they need a faith which will give them the hope of becoming better people in a better world.
At the bottom is the peg, which will plant the pole. Then there's a tiny little vestige of a canoe, the soul canoe, which in a sense is the female element. Then the ancestors. And at the top, the great prow representing male fertility and the end of the pole rearing up to heaven. They look so strange to us. And yet, don't we all have to struggle with the mystery of death?
I think that's why, for all their strangeness, these poles make an enormous impress upon those who are willing to spend time contemplating them.
Ah!